with that thing?
Well, this is our specialty glove. This is made from an inner tube tire, and it will really protect your hand. I'll show you the first one, and one of the things that we like to do is soak these clams in ice water. It makes them a little more forgiving when you want to open them up. And you see it has a short side and a long side. Mm-hmm. Long side and a short side. So I like to start at the short side. We just want to put it right in the crack of the clam where it comes together and just kind of squeeze it gently. Try to get one muscle, pull the knife out a bit, come around and get the other muscle. Now we want to capture the juice. Now you want to eat one raw so you can see how tender it is with Dave's clams. But try that for a clam that size. It's not tough at all.
No, it's not.
So that's pretty sweet. Would you like to try the technique?
I'll try, yes.
Okay, you want to protect your hand.
Okay, you got a short side.
Sharp knife, just put it there and then cut it. Oh, no, hang on. You're gonna hurt yourself. Let me take that from you again. Kind of squeeze your hand together. You have a little more force.
Okay, I'm gonna try again.
Yes, ma'am. I know you got the skills. I don't want you to hurt yourself, girl.
I don't want to either, but I'm like feeling like I really need to do this. I think my hand's too little.
No. You're in.
Yes.
You're in.
Thank God. Redemption.
Yeah, it doesn't take long for a pro to figure things out. And that's the interesting thing, is that the juice from this isn't going to be as salty, but to get that result, you have to go through the work of shucking the clam by hand.
So this dish you learned from a Gullah cook who was related to your life in what way?
Well, her name was Daisy Small, and my great aunt had a house at Polly's Island, a beach house. And Daisy, I learned a tremendous amount from her, her cobblers, her creoles.
What makes a cook a Gullah cook?
Well, I think, one, you have to be African-American. You know, after the Civil War, a lot of the Lowcountry was almost abandoned. And the black communities down here were almost left to their own devices as they kind of developed their own insular culture.
And what would you say are some of the classic, quintessential Gullah dishes?
For me, it's always been a little tomato-based kind of gumbo with okras, a little cornmeal dusted little finny fish. It's a simple but direct and very seasonal cuisine.
So I'm glad that I finally got this.
You did good.
And look at all the juice.
And all the clams.
Yeah.
For this dish, we're just gonna brown up a little bit of bacon. And this was always a breakfast dish for us. I think one of the most difficult things I have is to encourage the chefs to practice simplicity. So often we want to layer flavors and more flavors and more flavors. That's what all the French chefs taught me. Start with a really great ingredient and then just don't screw it up. Right. Don't mask it, don't hide it, don't cover it up. Okay, now we've got it nice and crisp. So we're gonna pour off most of the fat. So now we got some good sweet onion. We're just gonna just sweat that down. Here's our juice and give it a taste because you would think that it's gonna be really salty.
But it's not. It's not nearly as salty when you poach them.
It's saline, but it's not crazy salty. We're gonna get in some of that juice and let it come to a boil. We're gonna cook up a couple eggs too. Cook nice and slow, and then we're gonna add in our. We chopped the clams.
Chopped them up.
Daisy might not have used as much butter. There's something about parsley and shellfish that just is...
Really works.
It really works. And now we're gonna add in just enough saltines to give it a little thickening agent. That's the way Daisy did it. That's the way we're gonna do it.
So is this something that you would ever serve in one of your places for brunch?
We did run this dish several times at brunch, and the clam hash, and it was like... It didn't sell. And then just sprinkled bacon on top.
That looks awesome.
Right. That's not too salty. That's always my concern.
No, it's not too salty at all.
It's not too salty, and it's clammy.
It's great.
You can taste the clams. You can taste the freshness.
You absolutely can. It's great on the grits. They're a great vehicle for it.
And maybe we just need to rebrand this. Maybe we need to call it something else.
I'm going to think of a name for it.
If anybody could, you could.